NPP.
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 Pagatiri Sri Ram Raman Singh, and the Lieutenant Candidate of Tarun Singh Jumai AC. Now, may I now invite Sri Conrad K. Sharma, Honorable Chief Minister of Meghalaya, and also the NASA President of NASA People's Party, to say a few words on this function. And we have a small request from the girls' wing side to spare us some valuable time to have an introduction program with the girls' wing. Thank you.
Honorable Deputy Chief Minister of Manipur Government, Shri Goy Joy Kumar Ji, our Honorable President of the National People's Party, Manipur Unit, Shri Kaise Ji, our working President of the Party, Shri Jayanta Ji, our intending candidate for Sri Jamai constituency, Romain Ji, all the other senior party leaders who are present out here on the dais, including our national president of the NPYF, Ratika Ji, and all the supporters and leaders of the party who have come here to show your support for the NPP and its intending candidate, Sri Romain Ji. Friends, a lot has already been said regarding this coming election, so I will not take much of your time. We have two more programs to attend. I will be very brief in my speech. This morning when I woke up, I got the news about an attack that was done on some of our party leaders and party workers by another political party. Before this also, there were many incidents where there have been attacks on our intending candidate's house, and also incidents just now we heard that in Miami Fall also workers and leaders from other political parties are right now trying to take down the flag of NPP. What is this kind of politics that has been played by certain political parties? I don't understand. Is this what these MLAs, is this what these political parties want to teach our youth? Is this the way that we want to run our state and our region and our country? Is this the level of politics that things have gone down to? Is this the level of desperation of certain political parties? I want to ask. This is completely unacceptable. And we condemn those parties and those leaders who engage in such low level of politics. I want to tell you, NPP is a party that believes in positive politics. I tell this to all the youth that I meet. I say this in every platform that I get a chance, that we will show a new path. I want to tell the youth of NPP and the leaders of NPP, let us show the people of Manipur that we are different. that we are not like these political parties that engage in this kind of behavior and in this kind of violence and try to spoil the name of the people of Manipur. We will not tolerate this, and we will not follow this kind of footstep. I urge the youth of our party that we will show positive politics. We are here to move forward our state, our region, in terms of the development that we do. We are here to change and take forward the youth. 70% of the voters today in Manipur also are below the age of 40-45. And it is the duty of the leaders in the political parties to show the right path. Today, people are accepting the NPP in different parts of the Northeast because of the stand that we take, because of the positive politics that we talk about, because of the development work that we talk about, because we keep youth in the front, because we keep women in the front. In Meghalaya, a scheme called NRLM, which is Government of India's scheme, was started. Before I took over as Chief Minister, there were hardly 3,000 self-help groups, and hardly 10 crores had been released to them in the past 7 to 8 years of the past government. But when we took over as a government, we increased the number of self-help groups from a mere 5,000 to today at 35,000 groups of women self-help groups. From a mere 10 crores which was released to the women group, we have released in the last 3.5 years 120 crores to these women self-help groups. Our overall maternal mortality rate has gone down by 25%. Our entire malnutrition and undernourished children rate has gone down by over 90% in the state in 3.5 years. We have kept our women and our children and our youth as priority, not just in speech, not just in manifesto or constitution, but in the actual governance that we do in the state of Meghalaya. This is how we work, and this is how NPP works. And I'm going to show you that given the opportunity and given the chance, the NPP in Manipur also, if we leave the government, we will give priority to our youth. We will give priority to our women. We will give priority to our indigenous people. We will protect our people. That has been the foundation on which the NPP has been born and NPP has been made. So my friends, I will not take much time. I once again would like to thank you all for coming to this meeting. I would like to urge all of you that today the state of Manipur is looking at an alternative. They have seen and they have worked with other political parties. There is an undercurrent today where people of Manipur are looking for a new political party to lead up, to lead the state of Manipur. And that is where NPP will fill that vacuum, NPP will fill that space, and we will come out as the single largest party with your support. So with these few words, once again, I urge each and every one of you that we as a party would want to take things forward. But without the people's support, without the mandate from the people, we cannot move forward. So I urge you that in this coming election, please cast your valuable vote in favor of the NPP on the book symbol for the candidature of Sri Romain. And also, not just here, but also in other parts, in other constituencies also. Please tell your friends, your family, that in this election, we need a change. We need to see that the NPP needs a government. And with your support, I'm sure that we'll be able to achieve this. Thank you very much, and thank you.
Sir, Honourable Sir, we have a request from the girls.
Yes, we would always love to engage with the youth, and I would be doing that. but I would request that today we have two programs more left and people are already waiting for us. So tomorrow, our new president has fixed up a slot and a time for the interaction with the youth. So therefore, whichever groups are there, I will be happy to give time tomorrow morning. I sincerely apologize for not being able to do it today because we have two more programs left. And I don't want to do it in a hurried manner, because if we do it in a hurried manner, we will not be able to interact in a satisfying way. So therefore, please, I urge you, I request you that I will give time tomorrow morning. Thank you very much.
They will fight across the line, but we are confident and we are positive that this time the response that we are getting as a party is very positive. And a lot of people have decided to join the party, and we are very, very certain that the performance of the NPP will be like never before. And there's a very, very strong chance and high hope that we will come out as a single largest
party. So some of the incidents are just rolling out in Manipur that other political party, I don't want to take the name of other political party, but targeting NPP and NPP worker, NPP candidate, even pulling down the NPP flags. How you condemn such an incident?
I have already said in my speech that we condemn these kind of incidents. This is not the kind of politics that people of Manipur are used to, and nobody likes this kind of politics. And it's very, very unfortunate that some political parties, because of desperation, they are doing such kind of activities where they are targeting and creating violence in different constituencies. So we condemn it, but I urge our people, that is the NPP people, that we must refrain from any kind of violence. We must always be positive, and we must give the true political image that we as a party have always believed in, which is to be non-violent and which is to ensure that we play a positive and development-oriented politics. So we condemn the other parties and we urge our people to always be resistant.
So last one, sir, how you sort of explain the NPP slogan, Savior of Notice, sir?
Well, I'm very happy that people have started seeing NPP as an option. Obviously, we have always maintained that the Northeast is the priority of the NPP, and we are here to provide the platform for the people of Northeast. So we are happy that people have started seeing that and have started supporting and joining the party, and that's the reason why the party is growing from strength to strength. I'll be meeting you tomorrow at the press conference.
Sir, what time press conference?
Around about 11 o'clock.
Okay.